This method measures the fraction of aggregates that are stable after wetting of soil. Both larger aggregates, those greater than 2 millimeters, and smaller ones between 1/4 millimeter and 2 millimeters are measured. First, soil is pre-sieved to about 10 millimeter size, and then it is soaked in water. This large-sized soil is then sequentially washed on 2 millimeter and 0.25 millimeter or 250 micron sieves. Both of these stable fractions are then captured on filters or cloths and weighed. Soil particles less than 0.25 millimeters are discarded. First, the soil is passed through a large size sieve of size 8 millimeters to 12 millimeters. Larger clods should be gently broken by hand along natural planes of weakness, rather than just forcing them through the sieve. Large stones, and also large pieces of organic matter, can also be removed at this point. After sieving between 500 grams and 1 kilogram to create a representative batch of soil, 70 grams should be weighed for the analysis. Here are three batches of soil weighed out. They're 70 grams of each, so we can compare aggregate stability: a forest soil, a meadow soil with a long fallow, and an organic grain rotation with a fair amount of tillage. To start the analysis, a sieve is submerged in water so that the screen has 1 or 2 centimeters of water on it. Then the soil is poured onto the sieve and left for 5 minutes to soak, so that aggregates will slake and begin to break apart if they are not strong enough. After 5 minutes of soaking, the sieve is washed with an up and down motion, in and out of the water, 50 times in 2 minutes. A metronome app on a cell phone can be used, at 50 beats per minute, to time the washing. When using a metronome app at 50 beats per minute, the sieve should be put into the water on a first beat and then removed from the water in the second beat, according to the following rhythm.
Okay.
So that's it. That's our fraction. I think you can already see that it has less stable aggregate. Then the sieve is rinsed gently with a wash bottle. This should not be too aggressive so that we are not breaking down any more aggregates than were broken in the washing. The washed 2 millimeter fraction can then be set aside to be captured and dried later. Note that already at this stage there may be noticeable differences between different soils in aggregation, shown by differences in the amount of 2 millimeter water-stable aggregates. Next, the water and soil that was passed through the 2 millimeter sieve is poured into a 0.25 millimeter or 250 micron sieve. Enough water is added to cover the sieve and soil, and then the next smaller fraction of aggregates is washed out of the sample using the same rhythm of 50 strokes in 2 minutes, as was done before for the 2 millimeter fraction. This fraction is washed briefly in a similar way to the 2mm fraction, and then set aside to be captured later. Returning to the 2mm size fraction, this is emptied into a large bowl and then transferred to a filter or cloth to remove the water so that it can be dried. And wait. Thank you very much. Oops. Push some of these. For the 2mm size fraction, larger organic fragments that are floating in the bowl should be picked out, but smaller debris, less than about 2mm, can be left. Now the 2mm fraction should be captured on a cloth or filter for drying and weighing. If preferred, for a learning activity, and to save time if quantitative data is not needed, the aggregate fractions can be compared visually among fields or land uses instead of being dried and weighed. This process is now repeated for the 250 micron aggregate fraction. These drained soil fractions could now be compared visually before drying, if needed, which would save time and just provide a qualitative comparison between different fields or soils. Here we visually compare the different soils and land use management options with the different fractions. After drying in a drying oven or other dry, warm place, small stones can either be picked out by hand or sieved out of the larger 2mm aggregate fraction. Then each fraction is weighed with the cloth and filter. The weight of the cloth or filter is later subtracted out. After these stones are removed, each fraction's weight is divided by the initial weight of 70 grams of soil, but minus the weight of the smallest stones removed. These percentages can be used separately or added together to create a score for how well aggregated or structured a soil is. This table shows the final results from the three soils. We can see that the soil with tillage has substantially worse levels of aggregation than the meadow or forest soils. Here are some very approximate guidelines for scoring the aggregate stability of farmed soils. As seen just previously, meadow, grassland, and forest soils often have very high levels of aggregation. Grasses and fine-rooted legumes often serve to build soil aggregation, while frequent tillage will break it down. When scoring and comparing the aggregation of soils, another typical observation is that soils with lower aggregation status often have a greater proportion of aggregates in the lowest size fractions, so that the mean aggregate diameter will go down.